So emotion is nothing but the habit forming clay in us with which we play and form our own habit and find ourselves stuck up in our habit. How to get out of this? Once again, create another habit, neutralizes the previous habit. Otherwise, no use of knowing many good things. Just as we have created our own nature previously, we have to create a new nature now. Because we were capable of doing it in the past, we are capable of doing it now in the present also. So, let us begin to fuse the molds by using the heat of our creative activity. If the previous molds were formed of some wax and if they are solidified, there is no use of breaking them. We have to use some heat and make it liquid once again and form a new habit. So, every one of us is habituated in his thinking, unknowingly forming one's own habits again and again. And the process of forming the habit is what we call emotion. And habit formed is what we call reasonability. The formed habit is what we call reasoning. Formed habit is called reasoning. The formation of a habit is called emotion. This is the relationship between emotion and reason. Then there is the third aspect. In the second aspect, reasoning, you will find the real reasoning of nature. Then you will begin to steer the reasoning. You will gain mastery over nature's forces, mastery over your own psychological forces, and then you begin to steer them. You make things meaningful and you learn to use the machine. Just as the newly purchased car is used by the owner to learn driving. In the earlier days, the owner takes delight in traveling in the car for the pleasure of driving. But after some time, driving is not done independently for pleasure. Driving or no driving depends upon a purpose which is higher. If you have something to do in Brussels, then you will drive your car to Brussels. But the one who has purchased his car newly will go to Brussels to drive his car. There is a lot of difference. The one who has understood the real reasoning and the undercurrent of forces begins to understand nature in its true sense, its real faculties, the real faculties of mind and senses, and begins to use them because he is fond of using them, because he is still new with them, because he has discovered their forces that are concealed in them. But after some time, you will stop doing this and things are done by you and you stop doing anything. Just as respiration is being conducted by you and you are not conducting the respiration. You are doing your own work in the office or in the house or eating your own food while respiration is being conducted by you. You are talking to your friend in the car and driving is being conducted by your hands and your brain. This is the stage of things being done through you. And you are not doing anything at all. This is the real plane of intuition in which everything exists, from which everything comes out, into which everything fuses.